The bio reads, poet. Reads activist, youth worker, producer for the Vagina Monologues, reads college graduate, voted first ever feminist of the year. The bio never gives any further explanation as long as it sounds good on paper. Never asks what it means to be voted feminist of the year when feminism is not about women competing. It never tells of how I almost quit the Vagina Monologues after nearly drowning in a sea of white women's tears, how I stayed afloat by making buoys of my brown-skinned sisters who became the holiest of blessings when they held high my heavy spirits in their already calloused hands. The bio reads token. It tells all of how golden bright I shine. It does not tell of how I sometimes feel like someone has made a pinball machine of my life. The flippers are the people who bump me in whatever direction shines the bonus lights bite back at them. It does not tell of how I feel like careless hands have spent me, and I don't know if I was ever made of gold or just another coin to be played. It never tells the tales behind the degree or all I had to swallow to earn it. It never questions if that white piece of paper has made this blackness any less of a burden like it promised it would. When people ask me how it is that I got where I am today, I don't know if they want to hear the truth or some version of it that makes them think I am not as broken as they are. Don't know if they want to know how many nights I still cry alone in bed, how I overthink every little thing that I said and beat myself up for opening my mouth at all, of how many nights I cry alone in bed because I did not open my mouth at all, even though I know that silence is nothing more than the most gentle form of death. I do not think they want to hear about the shoulders that I've stepped on to get to where I am today, or the people who have willingly sacrificed themselves so I could become all that you see in front of you. I am not a self-made woman, and that is a hard thing to admit. I do not know what kind of woman that this makes me, and that is a hard thing to admit. If my bio read like the life that tries to hide behind it, it would read that I faked it until I made it, and now I don't know what parts of me are real anymore, that everything I appear to be is because I have gotten so good at hiding what it is I really am. It would read, I started smoking weed at age 13, and I haven't been sober since. Can't really remember most of my youth because of it, and I think that's a good thing. I guess I learned early the sense of power one gets when they control how thick the smoke is in their own lives. It would read, the girl who never learned to say no to others would read, the girl who learned that sometimes it doesn't matter if you do. It won't stop them from twisting your smile into a closed-lipped fortress that someone tried to destroy after they waged war on your body. It would tell you how tired this body is of being a battleground. How it knows there can be no winners in the civil war of the self. It would tell you how tired I am of men and women who think this body is all I'm worth. It would tell you I am tired of thinking this body is all I'm worth. Would be tired of being told that I need to come out as if I ever claimed a closet for a home. Would tell you I am tired of explaining to women that my love for men is not a betrayal. Would tell you I am tired of explaining to men that my masculinity is not a betrayal. It would tell you that I love like a forest fire, but I've never forgotten the taste of a firefighter's flesh. It would tell you how these flames once made me want to quit this body, but I found my soul hiding in the crevices of my hands when they folded themselves into a holy prayer and I crucified myself against a pen. If the bio read like the life that can no longer hide behind it, it would read, I am 23, going on burnt out, and sometimes I can't wait to be my own ashes, dancing freely in the wind.